Hi, I'm Glenn from Beena Web Media, and today we're going to expose what's inside of a computer. Many people are often worried about opening up their computer if they have to change a part, and this video will be totally helpful to understand what's inside and how easy it is for you to just take it apart and add your parts or take the parts out as you require. So, first thing you'll need to do is look for a tool called a screwdriver. Now I know they charge you $50 to $100 an hour at the computer shop, but this is basically what they use, is a screwdriver. So if you can use a screwdriver, you can change the parts in your computer. Okay, once you have your screwdriver, you just need to move your computer to where you can see the screws holding it together. And generally those are in the back. So here's the screw that we need to do first of all to take the top off, and it doesn't even require a screwdriver. It just comes off with a little thumb screw. This top part slides off, and sometimes the sides come off first and then the top, but in this model the top comes off first. To get inside this computer, protective sides have to be removed. And if you look at the top here, you'll see there's a couple of little handles here. And all you need to do is lift those up, and off comes the one side, and off comes the other side. Okay, now what you'll need to do is turn the computer to the side that is open. This side isn't the open side. This side is the open side. And you'll see there's quite a few components and wires in there, and at first it does look a little bit scary. But if you just take a quick look around, you'll see that the power comes in over here. So usually this box up here is called the power supply. That's where the power is sent out to wherever it's required, and is regulated inside here, where it takes the 120 volts and reduces it to microvolts that the computer can use. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to change the view, and we're going to look down into the computer, and we're going to start to try to figure out what is actually installed in this computer and begin to take it apart. Okay, now we're going to take a look at the components of the computer. And we'll just quickly point them out here. This is your power supply. Down here is your fan right here, which is attached to the chip. This is a card. This is a card. This is a card. This is a card. This is a CD or a DVD drive. In this case, it's a CD drive. And these are hard drives. Up here, you've got a little speaker. And basically that's the whole computer. You've got your wiring harness here, and down at the bottom here you've got your motherboard, which basically controls the whole operation. So component by component, we've got the power supply right there. Over here we have the CD drive. Down here we have hard drives. Over here we have the chip, the motherboard, and network and other cards. Okay, so let's proceed to take this apart. Okay, so the first thing we'll do is take out these cards here. Basically they all have a little screw. And we'll just take the screw out. Now of course, if you want to figure out what you've got in your computer and you want to see what's not in your computer, you basically go to the back here. You see you've got an input here, you've got a network input here, you've got a couple of network looks like a modem, a telephone jack, and a basically a speaker jack, a microphone jack, and here we've got video displays, and here we've got printer outputs, another USB outputs. Here's the on-off switch, here's the fan. So going back inside here, we're going to take the first card we're going to take out is the video display card. OK, Okay, that's what the video display card looks like. It's got a little fan on it. There's the two monitors. In this case, I believe this was a Matrox, and both of these were actually able to be used at the same time. So this was actually a great computer when I was using it, because I could pull the things apart from one screen to another. So here I might keep this card. I don't know if it will work in another computer, but I can always try to find that out in the future if I want to keep it. The next one we're going to take out is looks like the sound card and the onboard modem. And that's what that looks like. This one here is our network card. Now, some networks that you can use are local area networks that might use a cable, so that's the cable input, and here's the network jack. It's likely the CD controller as well. And here we've got a microphone and a couple other inputs, and this is another, I believe this would probably be the video, the regular standard video output that came with the computer, and then it was changed over to this other one. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to look down here, and oh, look what we found here. This is the memory. Down here, you see there's these two little buttons here. You push these buttons down if you want to add more memory. This is what the memory chip looks like. Usually little flat things. This here is a fan, and down here we've got the chip. So what we're going to do is we're going to see if we can pull this out of here. This looks like the hard drive. Okay, so take this one off over here. Plus there's some screws on the other side. So anyway, I'm not going to try to take this out. This says a Seagate Barracuda. This is a Seagate hard drive. Here you've got a hard drive controller. I believe this is the hard drive controller. And up here you've got your CD, DVD player. Okay, well anyway, that looks like it's the end of our lesson today. So that's how easy it is to open your computer. I wouldn't recommend opening your computer if it's under warranty. But if it's an older computer and you want to give it a try, it's quite easy to do yourself. If you need to install a FireWire card or something, basically you can do it yourself and save yourself $75, $100. So thanks for watching the video, and have a great day from Beena Web Media.